Hello friend, welcome to my channel 5 Minute Pediatric. Few days back I have posted question on Facebook. The question was related to this abdominal x-ray. This is exactly MCU, what we call micturating cystourethrogram. So with the help of this we can diagnose VUR. What is VUR? This is vesicoureteric reflux. So what happened in this condition? There is retrograde flow of urine from bladder to ureter, finally to the renal pelvis, and it causes damage to the kidney. So before going further or knowing grade of VUR, we must know the anatomy of kidney. So we have ureter, this is ureter coming from the bladder. And this is dilated part, what we call renal pelvis. This further divides into major calyxes and further divides into minor calyx. Here we have the renal papilla. So I will use all this terminology on the grade, on the grading. So we have ureter, renal pelvis, calyx, and papillary impression. So let's discuss one by one grading. Okay, because on the basis of grading, treatment are decided. Okay, so we have grade 1. So in what happens in grade 1, the ureter is, this is ureter, okay. This retrograde flow of urine up to the ureter only. And rest part, renal pelvis, calyxes, and papillary impression, you will get normal. Okay, what happens in grade 2? Grade 2, the it involves ureter and up to reaches to the renal pelvis. Okay, but there is no dilatation. Okay, now in grade 2, what happens? This reflux reaches up to here, and grade 1 into the ureter only, and it reaches up to the renal pelvis but without dilatation. Grade 2. Okay, rest calyx and papillary impression remains normal. Now we have grade 3. Okay, what happens in grade 3? So, grade 3, we have both the same condition, it reaches the pelvis, but there is dilatation of ureter and there is a mild dilatation of renal pelvis. But the calyx and renal papillary impression remains the normal. So now we have grade 3. Okay, now we have grade 4. What happens in grade 4? So there is moderate dilatation of ureter, renal pelvis, and it involves the calyxes also, but the papillary impression remains normal in grade 4. Okay, and grade 5, there is a gloss dilatation of ureter, there is a tortuosity of ureter, renal pelvis, and calyxes, and along with loss of papillary impression. So this is the simplest way that you can easily remember the grading, and grading are also asked in the examination. Okay, now from the treatment point of view, we have different urological society, but in what we follow here, in grade 1 and 2, okay, most of developed country kept it under observation. As VUR, we know that it is a common cause of recurrent UTI in children. So we have to follow some antibiotic prophylaxis. So these child in our country, what we follow, we have to follow the antibiotic prophylaxis we have to give this child, and we have to follow up regularly. And what happened in grade 3 and grade 4? So if the child is 0 to 5 years, okay, in this condition we give antibiotic prophylaxis and plus regular follow-up. Okay, and if the child is more than 5 years of age, okay, so if there is unilateral VUR, in that condition you have to give antibiotic prophylaxis. If it is bilateral, you have to follow the surgery. Okay, and grade 5, what you have to do, if the child is less than 1 year, okay, you have to give antibiotic prophylaxis. If the child is between 1 to 5 years, for unilateral, you have to give antibiotic prophylaxis. for bilateral condition, you have to go for surgery. If the child is more than 5 years of age, you have to go for surgery. So if the child comes to you with renal scarring more than 1 year of age, you have to go for surgery. These are the indication. And what we do in surgery, there is a renal, there is ureteric reimplantation surgery there. Okay, this is simplest way to remember the grade of VUR. So grade 1 only up to ureter, grade 2 up to pelvis without dilatation, grade 3 there is a mild dilatation of ureter and renal pelvis, in grade 4 there is a moderate dilatation without loss of papillary impression, in grade 5 there is gross dilatation, there is a tortuosity, and along with there is loss of renal papillary, there is a loss of papillary impression. So this is simplest way to remember. Hope so enjoyed this video. Kindly like, subscribe and follow my channel.